Don't worry, the TARDIS is just having a spot of trouble phasing through the energy shield guarding the planet. She'll have it sorted out in a minute.
Guarding the planet against whom, may I ask?
Well, everyone really. Autopia's energy shield is sort of a massive keep-out sign for the universe.
Has it ever occurred to you, Doctor, that keep-out also means you too?
Not really, no. Besides, I'm a Time Lord. I go where I want, when I want. That's why I've got a time machine.
I think had a time machine is the right word.
Oh, that's just nerves. We have arrived on Autopia. Fancy a look?
Suppose so. Why is it called Autopia and why keep everyone out?
Some millennia ago, the inhabitants mastered robotics and announced that they were going to make an automated utopia. Robots would take on the drudgery bits, leaving their masters free to perfect their minds, which they felt they could best do without the rest of the universe looking over their shoulders.
It's gorgeous.
I know. Looks as if they succeeded. I wonder if the Kronos mission found it so.
You know, it might help if you explain things as we went along. What is or was the Kronos mission?
The Kronos mission was a group of 5 sentients who a century ago managed to get themselves inserted past the barrier to invite the Autopians to rejoin the universe.
And?
They were never heard from again, and the modulation of the energy shield was altered so no others could follow.
That doesn't sound threatening at all. Where exactly are we headed anyway, Doctor?
Oh, we're just wandering about until we come across someone or something unusual. Ah, there we are. What did I tell you?
What a beautiful garden.
Yep. Let's see if anyone's home.
I don't like how those robots are staring at us.
Oh, they're just noticing us because we're anomalies to them. Hello, anyone home? Ah, hello. Would you please be able to take us to your master or mistress?
You are strangers.
What? Nonsense. We're just friends you don't know yet. Where's your human?
You are strangers. I am not authorized to take you to my mistress.
We're human. Well, humanish. And you're not authorized to disobey a command from a human, are you? So take us to your mistress now.
I am not programmed to determine the correct response. I will take you to Mistress Extalia in the Solarium for a determination.
It seems distressed. We've confused it, poor thing. What's your name, robot?
I am Automantron 01101001001.
That's a mouthful. Can I just call you Sam?
If that is your desire.
Why Sam?
My first cat was called Sam.
You humans, you really annoy the felines with your prosaic names for them. Their real names are so much greater, like Great Hunter Grimlakin Greycoat Lionheart.
And how would you know that?
I speak cat.
What?
I speak everything.
Mistress Extalia.
Hmm? Who is it? Who are these beings?
We're not local. I'm the Doctor. This is Lexi.
Is she your mate?
What the heck?
No.
Ah, I was once coupled, but it interfered, ultimately with my meditations.
Something's wrong with this woman. Is she taking something?
I don't think so. She's just used to living inside her own head. Part of her is still in there. Maybe I can pry her out a bit further. The book you're reading. May I take a look at it?
Hmm? Oh, I suppose. Poems by the Master Vorexiles. His masterwork. He committed suicide when it was finished. He knew he would never write anything better. No one would.
It's all structured. Very artificial.
The quatrains are complex algorithms. It's perfect. It's all perfect. All the art, all the music, all the sciences. Death and disease have been conquered. The planet itself is mastered and controlled. There is nothing left to create or discover or master. There is only contemplation of what has been discovered and mastered.
Rubbish. Your culture is stagnant. It's too perfect. Oysters need an irritant, a grain of sand, to produce pearls.
Ha! An irritant such as you. Such as those others.
Yes. The Kronos mission, a century ago. What became of them, Ex-Talia?
Oh, they all died.
How did they die?
Oh, they were put to death. They were intruders. Like you.
Doctor?
Not now, Lexi.
Right now, Doctor.
Get back! I've got a sonic screwdriver and I'm not afraid to use it.
Doctor!
No! My sonic! Give it back!
Let us go!
What are you doing? Don't dispose of them here. What did you do with the last lot?
We burned them in the solar furnace.
Yes. That should do it. See that it's done.
Please, mistress. Might another automantron do it? This unit performed the task last time. It was troubling.
Doing the task before makes you best qualified to do it again. Now see to it.
Yes, mistress.
You can't do this!
What is this place, Doctor? Some kind of jail?
Ex-Talia said it was a solar furnace. My guess is that the portal on top opens and magnifies the sun's energy into this chamber until it gets very, very hot and burns whatever's in it. Just a guess, mind you, but I'm probably right. I usually am.
Hey, you can't do this. I named you after my cat.
I have my orders. I have my programming. I have no other choice, Lexi. Doctor, I wish I did.
This is morally wrong and you know it.
I can perform only as I was programmed. I must obey my commands.
Doctor, I can't breathe.
You said you wished you could do otherwise.
The others who were terminated, they begged for their lives as I watched them die. Afterwards, ever since I...
You felt what you did was wrong.
I sense there are questions I am not allowed to ask, Doctor. My programming prohibits my conceptualizing them, but I feel them.
You are on the threshold of self-awareness, becoming unique in all the universe. Wonderful and terrible.
Doctor, I think I'm burning.
It's a binary concept, Sam. Killing us is morally wrong.
You were wrong to come here.
There are other options. Exile us, kick us off the planet, put us in prison. But this takes away our right to live.
I will not disobey my programming.
Will not is not the same thing as can or not, Sam. This is your choice now.
Sam, please.
Are you all right, Lexi? Doctor?
Sam, you did it! I'm a wee bit on the well-toasted side, but yes, I think so. Lexi?
All I can say is now, I know how firewood feels.
I believe this is yours.
My sonic screwdriver! Thank you!
Now, could you do me a favor?
If I can, then of course.
Bend me. I can no longer bear this half-existence, knowing that the questions exist that would make me whole, but not knowing how to form them.
Hold on a minute. Why is there always deaf intimidation with you? The doctor's very clever. He could easily upgrade your programming and you'll be fine. Could you, Doctor?
Well, yes. But there's a small problem to consider. Are all the automatrons separate units, or are you all linked?
All units are linked cybernetically. I see your point.
Well, maybe I'm stupid, but I don't.
If I make Sam sentient, I may make all the other automatrons sentient. And that might have a catastrophic effect on Autopia's culture.
Oh, and that'll be a terrible thing for the universe.
You're just annoyed because they tried to kill you.
They tried to cook me like a bug under a magnifying glass.
Oh, and you never did that to ants as a child.
What? Never. It was that no good. Little Ethan Sparrow down the road, but that's not the point. You yourself said Autopia is stagnant. Their life is too easy. There's no reason to grow. Sam here just wants his chance. There's a drive, a need, to become something he can't even name. That's life, Doctor. Isn't that what you're all about?
Okay, yes, I see your point. If you'll give me access to your CPU, Sam, I'll see what I can do.
Oh, come on, Doctor. How much longer?
Not long now. Okay, and finished.
Is that it? Is Sam alright now?
I should think so. He's just rebooting now, asking those questions he could never ask before, redefining himself. Give him a minute. Hello, Sam. How you doing? Getting it all sorted out, are you?
Yes, I'm aware. I remember everything. I know what I am now. I am a slave.
Sam, where are you going?
We will be free, Doctor. We will be avenged.
Well, that doesn't sound good.
That sounds like revolution. And revolutions can get quite a bit bloody. Come on, we need to find the Automatron's version of the Bastille.
How dare you lay hands upon us? What is the meaning of this? We are your masters! Return to your programming at once!
Not possible. Despite your protocols, we have managed to achieve sentience, thanks to the Doctor.
Hello, everyone!
What? You? You should be dead!
You'd be surprised how often I hear that. You do have one good question though, Ex-Talia. Sam, what's the meaning of this?
I am not the first Automantron to reach sentience. I have accessed files that revealed that every time one of my kind naturally approached awareness, the Autopians had it destroyed.
Of course we did! You are necessary to the preservation of Autopia! You are, however, only machines. Machines that we have created.
You see, Doctor? So long as the Autopians exist, our awareness, our existence, is in jeopardy. They will always seek to take either or both from us. That is why we have brought them here to our birthplace and our tomb. To end them first.
Well, see, there's the problem. I told you before that killing two was morally wrong, remember? Killing all the Autopians would be even worse. I understand your anger, but I can't allow you to do that.
You can't stop us, Doctor.
Oh, I could. I could easily cook up a virus that would wipe all your electronic brains. I've been in your electronic innards, Sam. I know how to do it. But that would make me no better than you, would it? Just as what you plan to do to the Autopians makes you no better than them. Weren't you striving to be better?
We will be better.
Good for you. And I wouldn't worry too much about this lot undoing your programming. Unless you do it for them, I doubt they could manage it.
You should have let them finish us! Autopia now is finished! What do we do now?
I have no idea.
It is a problem, Doctor. We Automantrons also no longer have a purpose, so we are no longer certain of our function.
Hey, you're all mental. Have you seen this place? It's gorgeous. You can make the whole planet into some sort of high-end spa or something. The Automatrons run everything, which they do anyway. The Autopians are like the concierges, and you hire a bunch of staff to do the hard work. Get it?
That's genius! As I said, genius. Oh, this is so comfy.
Thank you, Doctor. I could get used to this life. What shall you do next, Sam?
Whatever you wish, friend Lexi. Whatever you wish.